Hello and welcome to our next webinar with the topic ABB IBAS KNX Switch Actuators with Energy Functions. My name is Thorsten Reibel from the Competence Center Europe Smart Buildings, and I will present today together with Jürgen. Jürgen will take over also a part. What is planned? So we talk about our switch actuators, of course, especially about the components with energy functions, but I will start with a small overview of our complete new range of switch actuators before I come then to this topic, professional range with energy functions and new components just launched. I will give you a small preview about the ABB IBAS tool integration together with our switch actuators. Not yet available, but I think it's worth to see a small preview. And then Jürgen will continue with the topic ABB Acumatic Energy Analyzer KNX, QAS KNX, which perfectly fits to our new components. It's part of a complete solution called load shedding. This product is also now launched, the QAS with KNX interface, and we will show you something here, and also a practical demonstration will be shown by Jürgen. And finally, I come to the commercial and marketing aspects, as always, with a product launch of new products. Let's have a small look to our existing range of new switch actuators. We started exactly 1 year ago to launch the combi switch actuators. You remember this hopefully with the combination of switching functionality, but also shading functionality inside 9 components up to 24 channels. Then in February, we started the next launch with a standard switch actuator. Focus here is on providing a cost-optimized selection of products, but with all the other functions as well. And then also we started at that time to give to the market the first professional switch actuators, 4 components, and another 4 will come right now. And main topic here is the high inrush relay, which is possible, or high inrush current with the relays inside, which is possible to handle high inrush currents. So high switching capacity is one topic here. Let's have a small look to the components itself. Again, here is a combi switch actuators. So high channel density is another topic here, nice manual operation, and from 8 to 24 channels, 6 to 16 ampere. Standard components, standard switch actuator with the classical manual operation from 2 to 12 channels, also 6, 10 and 16 ampere. And the professional range, up to now it was, there were only 4 components, also with 2, 4, 8 and 12 channels, but these special relays for higher inrush current. And we added now further 4 components to the professional range with so-called energy functions, and this is right now available. Practically, it's successor of our components with current detection we had already in the last years, but we have not only current detection, current measurement inside per channel also, yes, but many more functions, and we call it now energy functions. But I will explain in the next slides how it works. Yeah, let's have a more detailed look into these new components. And before we do this, I would like to explain a bit why do we have now switch actuators with energy functions. What is the application, or what are the applications behind? What is the purpose? So we support the following applications. Submetering. We'll see later, we do not only measure the current, finally we have also energy consumption behind. So we can have a better transparency and optimization of energy consumptions down to the circuit, to each load. We can compare this way also the consumption behavior of some loads. We can detect energy thieves, so any consumers which are really taking energy though it's not necessary, because we can have a look into this consumption of such components. And if you have energy consumption, we can also allocate costs, at least internal splitting of costs is possible. So in a project, not externally with this billing, but it allows us also to find out what are the costs for some loads and assign it to the users. Yeah, and then we have the so-called topic monitoring of connected loads. Remember, detection of the malfunction of lamps was a typical application because we measure the current, we know the status of the relay, and out of this we can get some more information about the loads itself, but also about, let me say, the installation behind, also the relay contact and the cabling. Any malfunction behind can be detected this way. But I will explain this as well. Yeah, further application will be later the so-called load management, or we call it load shedding in this component, in the switch actuators. Practically, it's the avoidance of load peaks. So you don't want to have or don't want to exceed a certain load level. And this will be managed then by switching off some loads in an intelligent way. So not only switching off, you will see, resulting in reduction of cost, because you have to pay sometimes for load peaks, or you prevent any complete power cutoff in your installation because you're not allowed to exceed a certain power limit, or your installation is not prepared for this. So this is can be very, let me say, uncomfortable. It's better to create a kind of load shedding before you cut off everything. And this is now possible together with our components, the switch actuators with energy functions. Yeah, and then the topic, let me say, intelligent power networks, renewable energies, energy storage solutions. So real intelligent power networks behind. And to manage this the right way, we need also more information from the load behind, from each load, if possible. This allows us to do this with the new components here with energy functions, because we have real or more information from the loads itself and from the actual situation. So this is not only future, but partly also reality. But we are all working on this to consume as less as possible energy, to use as much as possible renewable energies, to store electric energy if possible, to use it then any other time. And all these needs an intelligent, complete intelligent power network. Yeah, and last but not least, you can also react on different tariffs. For example, if you know there is a low tariff, then you can turn on maybe loads, or if it's a high tariff, you try to switch off loads which are not really necessary at the moment, or you shift them to another period where it can be operated with lower costs. All these things are then possible. So let's summarize: intelligence, information and control down to individual loads and to individual circuits if needed. That's possible with components like the switch actuators with energy functions. But let's have a look how it works, how it looks like. The components itself are more or less similar to the components we had already since February, the professional range. So the same other hardware features, or features at all, channel current, so the relays, menu operation, software more or less. We have a new hardware inside to be prepared for further extensions in the future. All these things are possible. In addition, we have now current measurement per channel, resulting in a different hardware. So it's not possible to update the existing professional range by any firmware to have this function, because we need real measurement, current measurement first of all, resulting in a different hardware. And the current measurement is available per output. Remember, hopefully, our selection table we have for most of our components, also for the switch actuators, of course. And here it's very important, because one part of the selection table is the hardware performance of the relays. Means you can see here the performance of the relays, also depending on the load type, how much can be connected per channel, inrush current and so on. All these things are available. And of course, also for the new components, here we have one common table for the professional range without energy functions we have already. The older version means the components with so-called current detection at that time, 6.1 at the end. And our components now 6.2 with energy functions. So in hardware regarding the relay, it's not really different. It's the same. But if we look into the selection table and the software functions, which is also part of the selection table, you see differences. Here are the components with energy functions on the right. And you see almost all functions are available except these blind and shutter functionalities. This is only for the combi switch actuator. So, and you see here, we have special functions, so-called energy functions, and about these functions I will talk in the next slide. What does it mean? So if you have the first look to the ETS application, it's similar to the application we have already in our other new components. So all the functions we have there are also here available, like the templates, the freely programmable logic, for example, threshold functions, any time functions we have seen, forced operations, these central group objects to operate more or less all channels together with one telegram or one group address. And we have sometimes colored hints here inside the ETS application to give you some information you have to take care of maybe, and it's made for ETS5, the same as before, but now additionally the energy functions per channel. You see it here, it's marked here in red, load shedding, current measurement, and so on. All these things I will explain right now. Yeah, and of course a lot of parameters behind, partly I will show what is available here. Yeah, for our components with energy functions, for the switch actuators, we have created the so-called 4M slogan. 4M stands for measurement, metering, management, and monitoring. Yeah, describing in a short form what is behind. So measurement, remember, is a current measurement in principle. Out of this, we have metering available, power consumption, you will see. This load or load shedding solution we have, load management, is behind this management topic. And monitoring means, yeah, load monitoring, contact monitoring, so a lot of different things here behind. Yeah, to see this in a bit more detailed overview, you find it here. So 9 topics in principle: current measurement, power calculation, energy consumption, also calculation in principle, status of the load, whatever it means, not only on off, I can see already here, it's much more. Then this contact supervision, and monitoring of the current. We can have some more information of the load, of the installation behind. What is also new, we can create so-called energy groups, means out of the channels of one device, we can create a group, and this we can evaluate together regarding power, current, consumption, but also regarding the load monitoring. This is really nice. Yeah, and then I mentioned already, I will show a bit already what will be part of the ABB IBUS tool support for these components, including the components with energy functions, and some first screenshots I have already today. And again, it comes then probably at the end of the first quarter of next year. Yeah, and then last but not least, this load shedding solution, I will explain also here a bit. Good, so then let's go in some more details together with some screenshots of the ETS. So we start with a current measurement, of current per channel, like an energy meter. So it's the same kind of hardware behind. We have to measure really, otherwise it's not possible to have the other functions. Yeah, value can get as milliampere or ampere on the bus. We have also a delay here programmable, so that in any case of switching on or switching off behavior, we have a delay in measurement, so we measure only the continuous current. And all the values you can send on the bus, not only current, we will see later more, are, let me say, possible to send on the bus in different way. In case of change, cyclically or on request, means any other component or visualization ask for the value and then it will be sent only on the bus. Allows us to send values only on the bus if needed, and you can adapt this. So that is valid for all other other values sent on the bus. So we have now a real continuous true information about the current per channel if needed. So a bit more information about measurement and also accuracy. And I see just here a question which fits exactly to this next slide. Okay, measurement per channel, as mentioned, available as root mean square value. This is the value we have. So the root mean square value is in principle the same value which has the same thermal, also with a DC current, which has the same thermal impact to a load. Yeah, so if you take the same value with DC, you will have the same thermal effect than using a root mean square AC value. Practically, we can measure between 20 milliampere and 20 ampere. 20 ampere is the maximum due to the performance of the relay. Very important also is it's made for measurement of sinusoidal load current, not for DC current, because the way we measure needs AC, otherwise we cannot measure correctly, though you can switch DC loads with the relay. So this is not forbidden, and this is also possible with the relays. You see, we can switch up to 20 ampere with 20 volts, 24 volt DC, but we cannot measure this correctly anymore. Then. This you have to know. And but I think most of the loads are AC load. Yeah, and the accuracy is plus minus 2% of the measured value. Plus minus an offset, 20 milliampere, worst case consideration, but this is an additional possible failure. Of course, then you have in low measurements or low current measurements, a higher, let me say, failure than plus minus 2%. Yeah, this is so necessary to understand or to know, though practically you will have a better value or less than plus minus 20 milliampere, but take this please into account. So root mean square is our measured value. Yeah, and here I have copied a bit from the manual, which is sometimes quite nice. So it's a bit technical here, how it does it work, the measurement of current, like in energy meters. So we rectify the AC current, then it will be smoothed by an RC element, typical solution. And then we have a lower current on the secondary side of the transformer. So we do it via transformer. Means we need AC, otherwise we cannot use this. And then it will be calculated to have the root mean square value and works fine with sinusoidal current. Yeah, when we have the current, what else we need to have the power? The voltage. So do we measure the voltage? No, we don't measure. We are not a complete energy meter. We measure only current, but in most of the cases, the voltage should be constant. Means I can parametrize here in the parameters the typical voltage I have. If you say, no, I have a dynamic voltage, you can send also via the bus the dynamic voltage. Yeah, could be possible. So if you take a normal energy meter connected via our energy meter interface, which is measuring also the voltage, this can be sent to this device if it's really changing. But practically, I think it's constant. And as I mentioned, we have the root mean square for the current multiplied with voltage. We have also the root mean square value for the power available. So, but if you know the power factor, so that's the relation between active and reactive power, relation between active and apparent power, sorry, the power factor, then we can also calculate the active power. Of course, and you have to know the power factor, depends on your load. Also, this can be parametrized, or you send it again dynamically when you have the value, because it's a group object in the application as well. So, available then as watt or kilowatt on the bus, and this is further, let me say, measurement finally. Yeah? We have the calculation. So when we have power, we can have also the energy consumption multiplied with time. Power multiplied with time means the power consumption available as watt hour or kilowatt hour. So if you measure, then of course you start any time. The starting time of your energy consumption will be sent also on the bus. So let's say you have a total meter per channel, counting all the time. If you want, you can have also a so-called intermediate meter, because we have an additional one-bit group object available to start an intermediate meter or to stop an intermediate meter. This is possible. Yeah? So for a certain time period, you can have an additional value then available. So So I mentioned already it's more for internal purposes. If you would like to assign energy consumption to costs to dedicated users in your building, I mentioned we have in principle a kind of measurement like an energy meter, but only for current. Accuracy, I think, is also quite good, but it's not a real energy meter. Yeah, it's not in accordance with the MID standard measuring instruments directive, which is needed for classical energy meters, for billing at least. We can reset via KNX Telegram the values of measured energy consumption. This is not existing in energy meters, but here it's possible. So you see the group object here. But I think for internal assignments of costs or measurements or consumption values, this could be possible. So yeah, so measurement, calculation out of this, we have seen. What is about load monitoring? I mentioned already. We measure the current, we know about the status of the load. Why not evaluating the load depending on different current or power levels? So what do we do here? More or less, we can program so-called thresholds, yeah, to create different power or current ranges, and out of these ranges we can evaluate the load. And we said, okay, we know it's on or off, that's clear. If there's any current, is the load in standby, under load, normal operation mode, or an overload, too high current, or is it exceeding the real maximum threshold, which can be dangerous for the load itself. Yeah. So, and by programming these thresholds here in the ETS, we know exactly via a telegram in which level, on which range we are right now with our load, giving us some more options to evaluate the load. So we can do it either with current or power. And we program here all these thresholds. And then if you're in any range, we can send out either one byte telegram with a dedicated value behind from 0 to 6, I think, or you have individual one bit telegram as one bit telegrams for each of these ranges here. So up to 6 is possible. You can see, okay, I don't need so many. Maybe I need only the information, is it an overload mode? So from normal operation to overload, this is something I'm interested in, not more. You can also reduce this here. So I've enabled here the maximum, all thresholds which are possible. Yeah. So for example, it's possible now to detect, is a load maybe in standby mode, so very low current consumption, but still running anyhow. And we are in the night mode in a building, then we can say, okay, let's turn off this load. It's not necessary to run in standby mode anymore. So these options with these different ranges and evaluation of the load situation gives us here some more options. So let's come to the so-called contact status supervision. That's very simple in principle. Two kind of information are available. Remember, we have the current. We know there is any current flowing in our channel, and we know the status of the relay contact, open or close. And out of this, we have we can create two evaluations and further information about this. So let's take the first situation: contact is closed. We can evaluate this, and no current flows. This is not normal, of course. What can be the reason? Of course, anything is wrong with our installation or whatever behind, so cable interruption, circuit breaker has been tripped, device is not connected or damaged. Typically for lamp loads we use this to detect in most of the cases, okay, it's a lamp failure behind at the moment. Or seldom what can happen as well, a relay contact oxidized, or no power existing, phase failure for example. Yeah. This is all behind this one bit information we can send on the bus. Of course, then we have to evaluate what could be the real reason, but gives us a real first information. Okay, something is wrong, we have to check. Vice versa, contact open, but there's a current flowing. Neither, okay. So the reason could be a damaged contact. It's welded maybe. It's not operable anymore, the relay. So it's open. Though it's sent open, but it's glued. It's welded. Or somebody has used the menu operation. Because it's a classical menu operation, not via a keypad. So this is also something that this would result in such an information here. So two simple, let me say, possibilities. Of course, you can reset this alarm function then via KNX Telegram, but helps us to evaluate load or installation behind much better than before. So, and then we come to the so-called energy groups, means out of any channels in one device, we can create a group. We can put all these outputs together to one group to evaluate, typically regarding current, power, and energy consumption. And I have made here an example. So the total consumption per department is required, even independent of the load type. So you take all loads in one department together and evaluate them together. For example, regarding energy consumption, easily possible. Or what sockets you would like to evaluate here independent of the floor or the department, or total consumption of a floor, whatever you want. You can create any energy groups out of the device, the channels in one device. So, and how does it look like in the ETS? Up to 4 energy groups you can create. So, and each channel can member of one or of all these 4 groups. Can have also overlapping groups. You mark this only here. You do it for each channel, and then you have created an energy group. Very simple. Yeah. Yeah, the load monitoring I've just explained with these different ranges, load ranges, then can be also is also available then for the energy groups. So not only current, power, and energy consumptions, but also load monitoring per group available. Yeah, gives you also some more options here to evaluate not only individual channels, but group of channels. Yeah, and then the last main topic, so-called load shedding. What does it mean? I gave already a first information what's behind. The target is to prevent any electrical load peaks in a building due to limited power, which is only available, or my installation is not prepared for more, or I have to pay for this. Exceeding load peaks can be very costly. Depends on the local situation. But I remember also smaller projects where limited power is only available. If you exceed this power, then you will be disconnected from the power completely. And our target is to do it a better way, to turn off loads. Of course, anyhow, we have to turn off loads, but not altogether. Select it step by step. We start with the least important loads. If not sufficient, we go to the next level and we turn on again if we undershoot the power level. And so it's a bit more, much more intelligent than turning off the complete power. So how does it work? It does not work alone with the switch actuators with energy functions. We need a kind of central intelligent or master, which can handle these kind of load shedding or load management. So this can be at the moment two components, our energy analyzer KNX, QAS. We'll explain this a bit later in details. Or also, already existing for some years, energy actuator SES is also kind of load master software inside. So finally, what happens? All the loads which can send power values send it to this master. The master sums it up, compares it with a threshold programmed in the ETS. And if you exceed this threshold, it starts up to turn off loads which can be turned off. And we'll see later, we can turn off more or less all kind of loads via any actuator. Also starts to turn off. Starting with the least important ones, to go lower with the power. Yeah. So on which components can send power values, not only this switch actuator with energy functions, but also our energy module, our energy meter interface is real meters behind, and also the energy actuator. So we have already some components which can send the power values. And taking action via switching off of loads, possible in principle with any kind of actuators we will see. So a short look into two parameters. If you compare values with a threshold and to take action if you over or undershoot the threshold, it's always important to have kind of delay times and hysteresis function. We know this also from analog inputs where you compare other analog values. So we have here 3 parameters. When exceeding the load limit, we have a so-called reaction time, a delay up to 60 seconds. And when the power falls below, which normally means turning on the load again, we have also here so-called reaction times available, plus hysteresis to avoid any continuous switching, on and off switching, if you are just around this threshold at the moment. Standard, I think, in evaluating analog values with thresholds, also here available. Yeah, what do we do in the ETS, in the switch actuator with energy functions? Each output can be enabled with load shedding. Then you say which load shedding stage you would like to have. Up to 15 are possible. One is the lowest priority, 15 is the highest. So I start with the lowest to turn off. If I say, okay, this load at channel A is not so important, I can switch it off easily. Then you put it into the first load shedding stage. And then you say only what shall happen if you activate this load shedding or deactivate this load shedding stage. Typically, you say I switch off if it's active and I turn on if it's inactive, but there are some more options. Yeah, and how is it communicated? Via a one byte object. So on this one byte object from the master is the information load shedding active or not and which load shedding stage. And this one byte object, of course, is necessary for this switch actuator with energy functions. We have it here as a central group object available. Yeah, so it's a, let's say, special one byte telegram. Yeah. You see via a telegram, you can change also the shedding stage number here per output for channel A, B here in this example. It's also possible. So dynamic priorities for the load shedding stage here per channel. Yeah. This I have discussed already with this reaction here. If you have active or non-active load shedding stage, it's possible. You are totally flexible here. And the load shedding stage can be also changed via KNX telegram, as just shown, but also in future with the ABB IBUS tool. This will be then also possible. But I have a short preview how it looks like in the ABB IBUS tool later. Good. I mentioned I can assign not only the switch actuator with energy function, which has the special one byte object, but also any other. It's possible because we have not only one byte load shedding telegrams, so-called, but also one bit per load shedding stage. So 8 stages are available, means 8 additional 1-bit telegrams are then available to assign it to any other actuator. And 1 bit will be understood from any actuator to turn on and off the load behind. So no problem to integrate also further loads and further devices. And best is here to use then maybe a priority group object to turn off then with a higher priority than the local operation of the load. So nobody can override locally such a load shedding solution then. Okay. I would show a bit now from the ABB IBUS tool, what will be then available in the 3-4 months approximately, maybe end of quarter one is planned at the moment, regarding support of the ABB IBUS tool for our switch actuators. I hope, I think everybody knows our famous ABB IBUS tool, existing already for many years for many ABB devices. So it's made for ABB IBUS KNX devices to support during commissioning, during testing, during simulation. So it's a kind of visualization for one device at the same time to operate and to test everything. So we can really simulate, we can see the actual situation in a component together with a small tool free of charge and with a very, let me say, graphical and optical view into the component. So it's an optional tool, you don't have to use it, it's an offer. You don't change any ETS programming, so it's for sure not our target because this is part of the ETS itself. And it's free of charge available. And then also soon for our new switch actuators for the complete family of devices. And to give you a first preview, I have here 2 screenshots from switch actuators in general. This is most probably from a combi switch actuator because you see here status information also for shutter outputs, AB put together to be a shutter output, actual position, for example, status of the switching contact. You can operate also function, of course. You can activate the central command, for example, central switching. You can activate scenes or any safety functions. So all these things are available then for the, yeah, in this case, most probably combi switch actuator. And device diagnostic will be a topic extended compared with former components. So get here a lot of different information about the hardware itself, up to the CPU temperature, for example, how much memory you have used already, any order code or internal number will be possible to read out, maybe for any diagnostic purposes. Operating time, for example, will be available. So we call it device diagnostic. So a bit more than the classical functions behind. And I have also a screenshot now from the integration of the energy functions, so switch actuators with energy functions. Of course, you would like to display here the values we measure or calculate. You see it here, the power, total energy consumption. We see also here the load monitoring with the load ranges we have parameterized, the actual level we see here in red, and we can change also these thresholds here. So a lot of things are also changeable via the IBAS tool, but only things I can also change via Telegram. So we don't reprogram anything here. So let's wait still a bit, but we are really working on this, and it's very successful for all our other components, the ABB IBAS tool support, and for, of course, then also soon available for our switch actuators, for our new generation, for all components. Good, so I would hand over now to Jürgen. He would like to continue with the part, yeah, Energy Analyzer QAS KNX, because it's now also available, this product, and it's part of this load shedding solution I explained already a bit. So I hand over now to Jürgen, and he will continue both with the presentation, but he has also some practical demonstration for us available.
Hello and welcome. Jürgen Schilder is speaking. I will start my presentation on load control with a few words about the ABB Acumatic Energy Analyzer QAS. These are standalone devices for energy management applications. There are three different versions available. The so-called QAS 161 KNX. So this is an energy analyzer which gets all the meter values via KNX, like you see here on the right side of the picture. So we have here our KNX, different KNX meters. Then we have the QAS 3XX1M. This is for MBUS. So here we have two types for 16 or 64 meters. So this device gets all the meters via the MBUS protocol, and the QAS 4XX1 is also here. XX means 16 or 64 meters via Modbus. So in principle, all these three devices have the same features, yeah, maybe parameterization, applications, but only the protocol here is different. So during commissioning, we have here to do three different steps, the KNX version with the ETS, and the other two versions via different way. But all other topics later you will see, like for example, the instantaneous values or the dashboard is in principle, and the system settings are in principle the same. So all these energy analyzers, they log and store the values they get from the meters, MBUS, Modbus, or KNX. And not only ABB electricity meters, also like meters for water, gas, or heat meters can send here the values and can be also logged. So the device has an IP connections to the IP network, to the local IP network, and then via a standard browser, the end user can have access. And on the dashboard, he can see, for example, the values or do more about this energy system. The advantage is when you use ABB meters from the series A or B, they will be automatically detected and configured. So you have to do nothing, only a kind of scanning on the bus, and then these meters are configured. Third-party meters or non-ABB meters, for example, or meters which are not at the moment can be detected automatically, like different types of special network analyzer, like M4M, must be configured manually. But this is not really difficult. So then let's come to some features of this energy analyzers. Like here you can see a screenshot of the dashboard. The dashboard is visible for the end user when he logs in with his password. Then he can see maybe in a kind of rapid overview some values. It can be, for example, the energy, the frequency, the voltage. It depends what he creates, because this here is at the beginning empty, and via a button add a widget, he can configure his individual widget. Additionally, later you will see we can do here more things, for example, analysis. We can see historical meter values about minimum of the last 3 years of all 16 or 64 meters. So we can make a benchmark between two different meter points or meters, for example, via the same time period. Or, for example, we can also make a benchmarking via different time periods to see, okay, this, for example, building needs this month more energy like the other months before, and such things are possible. Additionally, the QoS energy analyzer can send reports, for example, the meter values, and send it via email or load it to a local FTP server. Yeah, this is also here still possible. Good, and later you will see this energy analyzers live in a practical demonstration. Additionally, the QoS for KNX 116.1 offers an additional load control management function. This is not available in the MBUS or MBUS, because there we have no possibility to switch off. Only here in the QoS version we have this load control management function. And here on the right side you can see a screenshot, and later I will come to this topic here live. So what is also new, that is that all the parameter settings about this load control is here now done in the ETS. And some values, for example, like here our load limit can be also changed via KNX Telegram or here under web user interface. More information about all these three different types of energy analyzers, including here the KNX settings, you will find on our webinar recording. We have given this webinar in January this year. And on our training data database, you will find here the presentation and also the complete video recording. And now this product is available, the KNX version. So here you can see the overview between our energy analyzer KNX here on the left side and different type of KNX meters. So here we have our local IP network with our PC, with a standard browser. We have access and can see here maybe our dashboard or do some things, or for example via your smartphone. So the first step is that the energy meter gets the meter, the energy analyzer gets the meter values here from our different meters. And in the second step, we want to do a load control. So the energy analyzer sends here the so-called load shedding stages to our devices and switch off here some loads. This can be, for example, our energy actuator, the switch actuator with energy functions, and for example, here also water meters, which can also send here values. Good, then let's start with the first step. Energy analyzer needs the meter values. So he zooms up all the power values he can get, for example, here from the meter interface, ZSS. This device gets all meter values here via infrared interface from our standard energy meters. Like here, for example, single phase meter, the B21. We can have here three phase meters or four wire meters with transformers, without transformers. So all type of meters are connect or can communicate via this infrared interface, and the meter interface sends all the meter values here to our energy analyzer KNX. The second one we can have is our energy actuator. The energy actuator consists in principle of a switch actuator with three channels and built inside our energy meter. So per channel and per complete device, we get all meter values, current, power, for example, and the energy and much more things, and send these meter values here to our energy analyzer. A similar device is the so-called energy module. Energy module, we have here no relays. So the device measures the energy which is connected here behind, like for example, also to maximum 20 amps here per channel, but no possibility to switch here on and off, only to send meter values. And our switch actuator here with energy functions, so we can send also the meter values per channel or per energy groups here to the energy analyzer. And of course, we are open, it's a standard KNX device, so we can here also get values from maybe third-party meters, electricity meters, or here water meter, gas meters, heat meters, and display also the values here in the web user interface. Good, then let's come to the first step here. to the first meter, which is my meter interface ZSS. So when I say, okay, this is my meter number one, for example, I can have here up to 16 meters. And then I go here in the settings in the ETS parameter of my energy analyzer. And on the right side, you will see here a screenshot. We can set here my meter number one, for example. This is my meter interface. This is a kind of template. And then I get all parameters which I need here for communication with my meter interface. So I can write here, for example, a user-friendly name, meter interface, or what a meter is measuring, if it's for HVAC, for heating, or for maybe light or socket outlets, the location, a serial number if I want. Then I can enable here parameter to get a request for the meter values if I say yes, and then the energy analyzer sends here a value, a request value that a meter interface responds with the meter values. Additionally, I can here monitor the communication between energy analyzer and meter interface. So when I say yes, I can say the value one, which must be sent cyclically here by the meter interface. And I can also enter here then a cycle time. So then I have to set here the parameter. It's a A or a B series meters or our former delta meters. And it's, for example, here 2-wire or 4-wire. So I have here to do some settings, which must fit, of course, here to my meter. What is now important, if I want to use these power values also for the load control function, which I show you later, then we have to say yes. So and then these values will be used internally for our load control. So then let's come to another KNX meter, which can be the energy actuator or also the energy module, which have nearly the same features. So I said here, for example, you are my meter number one, and then I go here to the parameters and can select here you are ABB switch energy actuator or energy module. Again, I can enter here the name, user friendly name, and get also here the parameters I need for the communication to the energy actuator. And do not forget, when I want to use also here the power values for load control, I have here to enable this and say, yes, I want to use the total power of my energy actuator for load control, yes. Or I can say only maybe the channel A, only channel B, or channel A and B, or channel C and D is also possible. But I want to use the complete power values here, then I say here total. So next parameter, I can use, for example, also here our new switch actuative energy functions to get all the meter values. So here in the ETS of the energy analyzer, I have to select here your electricity generic meter. So then I can enter here again the name, for example, this is my switch actuator, channel A or channel B, what we have connected. And again, here some parameters, for example, here again, the request of the values, the cycling monitoring, like here, via the group object in operation, I can enter the cycle time. And of course, we have here only one channel we want to monitor. We want to get the meter values. We say here a 2-wire meter, no tariff. And we want to have the active energy, for example, here in watt hours, or you can change it also in kilowatt hours. But I prefer here my training board because I have only some watts, of course, the watt hours. Good. And then I get all these meter values here in my dashboard. And that's what I want to show you now live. So just a second. I share now my desktop and show you here live the dashboard. So now I'm logged in the dashboard via the IP address. You see, this is my local IP address. And then I have here created my own dashboard. At the beginning, the dashboard here is empty. And then the user can create here his own dashboard. So we have here a button, so-called edit button, and then he can click there and a window pops up, and then he can create here his own dashboard, for example. So then let's go. Good, so here on the left side, you see my meter number one, which is my ZSS meter interface. You see here the energy, here we see the power, and for example, here the current. The next column, I have here my energy actuator, the channel A. You see here 24 watts. I have connected here incandescent lamps with 25 watts. The switch energy actuator channel B, you see at the moment zero because the channel B is switched off. Or here my switch actuator, this is my output A, is at the moment switched off. So we see here zero. And here we have, for example, the energy group. The energy group one of my switch actuator belongs of the output A, B, C, and D, for example. And again, here we can see the current. So this dashboard can be created here by the end user. Then let me go to the menu analytics, for example. The menu analytics is also for the end user, so the end user can also see here, for example, some historical values, like here per day, per week, per month, per year, for example, of the complete meter, of all the meters. I have here kind, maybe the, let me say, flat structure. I have here my 4 meters, yeah, the meter interface, the switch the energy actuator, the switch actuator channel A, and my energy group 1. So I can click, for example, here also on my energy actuator, and then you can see here maybe his load profile. So what is good to see is here the window instantaneous value. And the instantaneous value, I can see here, for example, on the left side, I have selected the energy actuator. Then I can see here at the moment, my total power are 74 watts. I have connected 3 incandescent lamps. Each incandescent lamp has 25 watts per channel. So like here, for example, on my channel number 1, I have here 25 watts. Channel number 2, which is here my phase, my L2, I have also here 25 watts, and also here my channel number 3. And all 3 channels, yeah, summed up, equals here my 75 watts. Yeah, or here maybe the switch actuator with energy functions is my channel A. At the moment, you see here 280 watt hours, but the channel A is now switched off. So we can see here power total 0 and no current. And I switch on now my output A. Yeah, then you will see here it goes up to 25 watts. Yeah, so I can switch here off again. Maybe you can hear the clicking of the relay. Yeah, and then after a short time, you will see he goes back to 0. These are the so-called maybe instantaneous values sent by the energy actuator with energy function. Good, only a short introduction. Then let me stop here with sharing and I go back to my presentation. Now load control. So load control means we have again here our energy analyzer, which is our so-called master. Yeah, and the first step, he got all the meter values, the power from all our devices. And then depending on our load limit, we can set, for example, via the ETS parameter or via KNX telegram or also in the web user interface. Yeah, he sent here shedding stages between 1 and 8. So now when the active power now exceeds the limit, and then he starts sending the first shedding station. If it's still higher or above the load limit, then he sent the next shedding stage, number 2, number 3, and so on. So this is a 1-byte telegram, and this 1-byte telegram is linked, for example, to our energy actuator, because he can listen to this energy master, yeah, or to our switch actuator with energy functions. Other devices like the meter interface or the energy module, here we have no switching function inside, yeah, so they cannot integrate it in the load management. So additionally, we can also integrate in our load control system other devices like former switch actuators from a former generation, or the switch actuator standard, for example, or the combi switch actuator are also possible. And other devices, maybe for example from HVAC, like a fan coil controller or fan coil actuator or a split unit gateway. So nearly all kind of devices or actuators can here be integrated, because the communication between our master and these devices here happens via 1-bit telegrams. Via 1-bit, so the energy the energy analyzer offers here several 1-bit objects, and this depends on the shedding stage, are linked here to the switch actuator, fan coil controller, split unit gateway, and we use here the so-called forced operation function. Yeah, this has a higher priority than the standard operation via a standard control element, for example. This is what I show you now in the next slides. Good, in the energy analyzer QoS, we have here a separate menu, which is called load control. And here you can see in a graphical way, for example, the active power and the overview of all the meters. That's what I show you, yeah, also in a practical demonstration soon. So, but let me go at first to some parameters of the energy analyzer QoS. So when we want to use this load control function in the ETS, we say yes, enable load control. Then we can enter here the maximum number of load shedding stages between 1 and 8. So 1 is the, he starts with the shedding stage 1. So if the limit is still above, then he sends the value 2, value 3, and so on. So here we have to enter the load limit, like in my example, 100 watts, because I have here only 25 watts incandescent lamps. Is it possible to change the load limit via group object, via KNX telegram? Yes, if you want, and then we get this group object. Then we have the reaction time when exceeding the load limit. So minimum 2 seconds, the load limit must be exceeded, and then he starts sending the shedding stage. So if you have small, maybe power peaks about 500 milliseconds, nothing happens. So we need here minimum 2 seconds. The limit must be over, the power must be over the limit. And then after 30 seconds, this is the reaction time when falling below the limit. So when he sends the shedding station, shedding stages, the actuators switch off and the active power falls below our limit. And then after 30 seconds, the energy analyzer goes backwards and with the shedding stages from 4, 3, 2, and maybe the loads can be switched on. So here we have a minimum time of 30 seconds. A hysterese, if we want. So for hysterese means about our load limit, 100 watts, for example, plus minus percent, we can also enter here. So it is also possible to change the hysterese, the reaction time, the load limit via the user interface. Yes, later we'll see, then we can do it. And what about the values when we make a download, for example? Yeah, should be also overwritten, the hysterese, reaction time, and the load limit, yes or no? So what else? And what about the load control? Should it be active, for example, after restart, after download? Yes or no? When we say here, for example, 0, then it's automatically activated. If we say no, then it's deactivated. Good. These are the parameters of the energy analyzer. Then let's go to the configuration of the switch actuator, for example, with energy functions. So we go here to the standard configuration, which belongs to the complete device. We enable our outputs and, of course, the energy functions here in my channel A, B, C, D, E, F, and so on. So what else? If we want to use the energy groups, we can also enable here these groups. Good, then let's go to our channels. Here, for example, I have an 8-volt device, so I have here switch actuator channel A, B, C, and so on. And then we can use the energy functions, the load control functions per channel. Like, for example, here, this is my channel number A, switch actuator A. I go here to the submenu functions, enable, and enable here the function load shedding. Yes. Okay. And then I get automatically here a new submenu, which is load shedding. So in here, I can use all the settings which I have made in the template, or I can make here individual settings. So let's take here individual settings. Then I get all the parameters. So at first, I can enter here the shedding stage. Yeah. Remember, shedding stage 1 is the first one which sends the energy analyzer when the load limit, when the power exceeds the limit. 1, 2, 3, or so on. So next one parameter is the load shedding. Should it be possible to change it via group address? Yes or no? When we say yes, and then we get this group object. And override the load shedding stage at a download? Yes or no? Reaction, for example, on active load shedding stage. So now, when our active power exceeds the limit, the energy analyzer sends the value shedding stage number 1. What should happen with the output? Should he switch off or on? I think in the most cases, of course, we say off because we want to reduce the power. But in some cases, you want to switch on. Yeah? To trigger, for example, a buzzer or siren, to give an acoustic signal, oh, we have now exceeded our limit. Then we can say here on. And the reaction of revoke of load shedding stage, for example, now when the energy analyzer sends the value 0, for example, no more active shedding stage, what should happen? No reaction. So what does it mean? No reaction means that here the output is still off like before, or it can be switched on, it can be switched off, or refreshed to the KNX state. So this is the last telegram the device receives on the switch output A, for example. Good. Okay. And when we use our switch actuators without energy functions or older switch actuators, former generation, then we can use here the scroll function via the priority, like here also the Combin standard actuators. So we go to these switch actuators, we go to functions, and here we enable the so-called priority and safety operation. Then we get another submenu, safety, and here we can use, for example, the so-called forced operation, the block or priority 1, 2, 3. But the best way is here to use the forced operation 1-bit, because this feature, forced operation, are available in, I think, 99% of all KNX actuators. So maybe this is a must in all actuators. So remember, at the beginning of the EIP KNX system, we used the so-called 2-bit priority. This is also here possible, but now we use the forced 1-bit operation. So select here, activated 1-bit, and then be careful, we have to use here zero active. What does it mean? The energy analyzer sends a 1-bit telegram, like for example if the shedding stage 1, with the value 0. 0 means activate now my my shedding stage 1 and switch off, for example. So that's why we have to use here the 0 active version, not a 1 active. And then when the forced operation is active, what should happen with the output? Off, of course, because off means switch off the output to reduce our power limit. And for example, when the blocking, for example, is now resetted, then what should happen? On, off, or the refreshed KNX value. So via this parameter forced operation, we can also integrate here our standard switch actuator, combi switch actuator, and other devices. So, and this feature of the forced operation is also available in other devices like fan coil controllers, fan coil actuators, bit unit gateways. Yeah. So here, for example, you go in the fan coil controller, FCCS, to the menu, monitoring and safety, and then enable here the forced operation, the same like before, with the 1-bit and 0 active. Yeah, and then we can set here the value, the control value, the fan output, and also here the relay output. What should happen if the forced operation here is now active and sent here by a load shedding stage by the energy analyzer. Good, here only a short overview about linking of the group addresses. So here on the left side, you have all group objects of the energy analyzer for load control. And here on the right side, I have a standard energy actuator, a switch actuator with energy functions, and here maybe some switch actuator or without energy functions, or fan coil actuator, combi switch actuator. So what we have to do, the easiest way is to link here one group address, it's a 1 byte, to the object load shedding stage, to this object, and then link it here to the load control shedding stage of the energy actuator, to my switch actuator with energy function, and so on. So it's only necessary to have one group address. And depending on this value, it can be 1, 2, 3, the devices go here in a different shedding stage and switch off. The devices without this 1-byte object, we can use here the so-called 1-bit shedding stage objects. So we get here 1-bit object for shedding stage 1, shedding stage 2. So now when the device sends out shedding stage 1, this object will be triggered at send a telegram with the value 0. This is, for example, linked here to my switch output A forced operation, and then the output A switches off, for example. Yeah. And the channel B, for example, is linked to the shedding stage 2, channel C, stage output 3, and so on. This is the principle to use here this forced operation. Good, only a short impression. So what is also possible with this energy analyzer, before I come to the practical demonstration, is a lot of more things. Like here, you see the energy analyzer KNX with our KNX devices, the switch actuative energy functions, our load control. Here the MBUS and Modbus energy analyzer. So all these devices have similar functions. So they can send, for example, here also the values via email, sent out maybe every day, every week, or all the meter values can be also stored on a FTP server in Microsoft Excel or CSV. This can be also done by the other energy analyzer, still possible. And the end user have access via the IP address here to our different energy analyzer. But we can do more. All this energy analyzer can also provide Modbus TCP values. So via other system, for example, our building automation controller, BACS, or a SCADA system or building management system, these devices can listen to this Modbus TCP values and maybe make it here visible or can calculate it or use it for other things. Here is also possible, for example, to convert these Modbus TCP telegrams also into KNXNet IP telegrams and send it here in a KNX line, or here also via a SCADA system. So maybe when you have here a panel, then you can see also the MBUS meter values collected here, convert to Modbus TCP, send here to a SCADA system, convert to KNX NetIP, and send it here into a KNX world. So only to show that we can do really a lot of things with this energy analyzers, and that's really important part of our buildings automation world. Good, then let's come to a practical demonstration of this load control. We go here to this next menu, load control. So load control, and then we get here an overview. So we see at the moment, here on the left side, the status. So my load control is stopped. I can now start this load control, or later you will see the status above load limit or lower than load limit. You can see here the total power at the moment, 150 watts. I think 6 of my incandescent lamps are now switched on. The shedding stage, 0. My load limit, 110 watts. The hysteresis. So these values can be also changed by the end users. So when you click here on the button edit, remember the parameter before on the ATS, and then the end user has the possibility here to change the load limit, the hysteresis or the reaction time, 2 seconds and longer, or the reaction time when falling below, and save the values. So, okay. Or here via drag and drop, you can also change here maybe the values. Okay, but I say no, do not change the values. Good, here on the right side, you can see the meter values. Like for example, the first one is my meter interface ZSS. At the moment, he sends 25 watts, the energy actuator on my channel 1, channel A, 25 watts, channel B, channel C, and you see total 75 watts. And now when I switch off here, for example, my channel number A, then you will see he goes back to 0 and I have only 50 watts. My switch actuator only 0, it is switched off. And my energy group 1 is switched on with 2 channels, so I have here 50 watts. So at the moment, I have here now 129 watts. I switch off some more devices that I fall below my load limit. Right now I will end. I start now my load control here on the right side. All right, I have here a button, start load control. Okay, or I can send it also via KNX Telegram, and then you will see here the status is okay, load control is now active. So I switch on some electrical loads, like for example here, and then you will see what happens. So wait. Yeah, you see I'm now above my load limit. So shedding stage 1, shedding stage 2. So the energy analyzer starts with sending a telegram, shedding stage 1, but then we are still above our load limit, shedding stage 2, and then shedding stage number 3. So, and then you will see here on the right side, my devices which were linked with the shedding stage, like my switch actuator, my energy group, you see here 0. So at the moment I have here 50 watts. And after the time, for example, after 30 seconds, the energy analyzer goes backwards. At the moment you see shedding stage 3. Now 30 seconds later he sent a telegram, shedding stage 2. We are still above our load limit. Then he's waiting again 30 seconds, and then he goes again backwards and send shedding stage number 1, and then 30 seconds again shedding stage 0. So this here is still possible. So this is how the energy analyzer works. Good, okay, only a short impression. I think we are a little bit over the time. So I want to stop now sharing my desktop. Now I'm at the end of my presentation. Finally, I would like to refer to the next online learning session about ABB iBus KNX Switch Actor energy functions in detail. So this session will take place next Tuesday, it's the 24th of November. And in this session, we show more detailed information about the energy and load control, such as the complete parameter settings, in the meters, for example, in the energy actuator and the switch actuator, and of course the assignment of the group addresses which object must be linked, and some more practical demonstrations. Good, so far my part, and I hand back to Thorsten.
Yeah, thank you, Jürgen. Great. So we could see everything live. Fantastic. Maybe you need an additional technical IP network at home anytime, but we could see everything. It was fine so far. No problem. Good. So I have, as always, for our products we launch right now, some commercial and marketing aspects. I would like to show very fast. It's not much anymore. So products are available. Here are the types, 2, 4, 8, and 12 channels, and the order codes. It's on stock. Also our range overview we have updated. also the new switch actuators with energy functions are inside now. You find it on our homepage here. We have a so-called microsite to all these products which are just launched, also for the switch actuators professional, where you find also then the links to further content, like the product page, where you get everything at the moment. So all everything is online as well. Remember we have these former versions, the 6.1 version with the so-called current detection, more or less replaced now by the new components. You see it's very easy to transform the older components to the newer ones. It's more or less the same, only some more functions, energy functions as we have seen, but channel-wise and size-wise, it's the same in principle. So regarding training support, so not only demonstration and training presentations, we are just working on this new training board. It's just under construction at our supplier or provider of these boards. And it's not only an energy function actuator, let me say, board. It's a multi-component board, consists of the QAS, Energy Analyzer KNX, energy actuator with the three channels, metering interface, ZSS with a meter, plus a two-fold switch actuator professional with energy functions. But out of these all components, we have seen already a bit in Jürgen's demonstration, we can create a complete solution to show everything around energy functions with all these components. So just under construction will be then sent to the training stations or training the training stations in the countries. And we think it will be available in the first quarter of next year. Plus, of course, also the training package, which has not only the presentation, but also the exercises and so on. Good, let's summarize everything around these components, the switch actuator component at least. Principle we know already, most of the features. So high inrush current, classical menu operation. We have these proven connection terminals, very good ETS application. We are prepared for the IBUS 2 support very soon. We have seen the first screenshots. Our hardware inside is really new and prepared for further extension in the next future, produced and designed in Germany as a further feature. And of course, we have these new energy functions. Everything was explained already and shown a bit. So again, my slogan or my sentence I have said already at the beginning, we would like to have intelligence, information and control down to individual loads and circuits. Yeah? To have all these solutions like metering, like intelligent power networks and all the benefits out of this available together with these components. So we are really prepared with such components also for intelligent networks, let's say, powerful solutions in this way. Final slides over the time a bit. So training material you find on our training qualification database as always, our calendar, all these online sessions at the moment, no classroom trainings, neither our certified trainings, but we completely plan for the next year, at least our dates. For sure not at the beginning possible to continue with any presence or classroom trainings, but we are still optimistic and we can be optimistic, I think, to proceed also with live trainings anytime in the next year. Yeah, what is planned next? Further webinar this year in December about Free at Home. Topic API, application programming interface, a kind of open interface to integrate other solutions, other systems, other protocols. It's not an ABB invention, it's a real topic on the market. And Free at Home is quite well prepared for this. And Martin will explain what is the actual status and what we are doing right now and what is possible in this API topic. And online learning session, Jürgen already mentioned a bit. Next Tuesday, more details about these solutions we have just shown today. So switch actuator with energy functions and everything around. We go in some more details of the ETS. We are continuing with also already next week on Thursday then with, one week later, with Bush control charts again, but now Philips Huey integration, so lighting integration, Philips Huey it's a big topic and we were getting some requests in this regard. Continuing endless Free at Home in December with online learning sessions, some basics here, so a bit overview of the products, the way of installation, also feedback from the market and also in Free at Home, further integrations of other applications, whatever it means. Yeah. So also in December then. That's our next plans for further online sessions. invitation will come. And yeah, I hope to see you then as well. Let's say thank you to you. Thank you for your participation and patience. I hope it was interesting. Wait for our next sessions. We invite you. See you next time. Thank you. Bye-bye. Ciao.